Bray Wyatt was released from his WWE contract last Saturday, abruptly ending his 12-year run with the company. Wyatt's release caught countless people in the wrestling world by surprise. Not only was he among the longest-tenured superstars on the WWE roster, but he was also a top merchandise seller. Wyatt reportedly signed a new deal with the company just last year, and he was apparently cleared for a return to wrestling just last week. It's simply hard to understand how it got to this point. Wyatt held the Universal Championship twice over a 10-month span, and he was always featured in the main event or top mid-card scenes. Fans of Wyatt will obviously feel the sting of his departure for a little while. But over the long run, they'll come to realize that his release from WWE was for the better. Wyatt was constantly misused and poorly booked. There have been way too many recent cases of WWE failing to capitalize on the popularity and skill sets of top-tier superstars. And Wyatt's name instantly comes to mind when you think of underused talents. Few superstars can match Wyatt's creativity and especially the ability to reinvent his character time and time again. WWE had an ultra-unique talent here, but they just never maximized the potential of the third-generation superstar. Wyatt's run as The Fiend wasn't the same after he inexplicably lost to Goldberg, a part-timer, at Super Showdown 2020. Given Roman Reigns' incredible success as a heel, it's hard to complain about him ending Wyatt's second Universal title reign. It lasted just 6 days at Payback. Wyatt moved over to Raw via the 2020 WWE draft and entered a program with Randy Orton. He lost to the Viper at the TLC, Tables, Ladders and Chairs pay-per-view on December 20th, and was kept off of television for 3 months. WWE's special plan. Bring Wyatt back at Fastlane 3 months later to set up another showdown with Orton at WrestleMania 37. Then the highly anticipated match ends with Orton quickly defeating Wyatt via pinfall, thanks to Alexa Bliss's betrayal. On the post-WrestleMania edition of Raw, April 12th, Wyatt announced he was looking for a fresh start in a Firefly Funhouse segment. That wound up being his final appearance on WWE programming. To recap, his brilliant Universal Championship reign ended at the hands of Goldberg, who dropped the title a few weeks later to Braun Strowman at WrestleMania 36. Then, over a four-month span, Wyatt loses twice to Orton. How on earth can this be considered logical and rational booking? Limited options for Wyatt in WWE. An elite talent like Bray Wyatt shouldn't be in the mid-card or tag team scene. He should be a perennial main eventer, but it was clear that WWE wasn't going to go that route with him. A program with WWE champion Bobby Lashley would have been enticing and all, but the latter will actually face Goldberg at SummerSlam. Considering WWE's usage of Wyatt, it's hard to imagine that they would have placed him in a feud with Goldberg or Lashley after SummerSlam anyway. Roman Reigns competes on the SmackDown brand, and WWE missed the opportunity to run this feud while they had the chance. Clearly, there wasn't a spot for Wyatt in the long-term main event scene. Surely, another promotion will have no problem pushing him as one of their top stars. Bray Wyatt needs creative input and freedom. Wyatt reportedly grew overprotective, and understandably so, of his wrestling character, and he apparently didn't see eye to eye with WWE chairman Vince McMahon. Clearly, it just wasn't going to work much longer. AEW is notorious for granting more freedom to wrestlers when it comes to character development and promos. Jon Moxley and Matt Hardy have been vocal about their frustrations with WWE's creative process. Whether it's AEW, Ring of Honor, New Japan Pro Wrestling or Impact Wrestling, it's safe to assume that Wyatt will get plenty of input when it comes to developing his next wrestling persona. A unique talent like Wyatt shouldn't have to go off a script time and time again, and it's impossible to envision him getting booked poorly elsewhere like in WWE. It just isn't plausible. AEW appears to be the front runner to land Wyatt. They're supposedly about to bring in both CM Punk and Daniel Bryan. If AEW also signs Wyatt, who's under a 90-day non-compete clause, the possibilities will be endless. They can do so much with the former Universal Champion. Imagine a program with Chris Jericho, Darby Allin, or Punk, or Bryan, or even wrestling icon Sting. The list goes on and on. WWE had more than enough chances to capitalize on Wyatt's star power, popularity and all-around talents. They failed time and time again, and it's why Wyatt's release is actually a blessing in disguise. They say, when one door closes, a new one opens. Well, that new door is going to be a lot more welcoming, adventurous and thrilling for Wyatt.
Oh, let me up with a bright smile on now. Put me in the door, so won't get lost now. To the moonlight,